In this video, we'll look at how to download and install PostgreSQL database on Windows system. So here I have Windows 10 system, so we'll install on Windows 10 system. But you can follow the same process for other Windows version. Let's get started. So first, we'll download PostgreSQL database. So for that, let's open our Chrome browser. And here in the search bar, search for PostgreSQL. So once you search for PostgreSQL download, here you can see the official website of PostgreSQL. So just click on it. So once you click on this one, here in the next page you're gonna see the PostgreSQL downloads, and here we have support for Linux, macOS, Windows and Solaris and BSD systems. So we're gonna install on Windows system. So let's click on Windows. So once you click on the Windows, okay, here you can see the version of PostgreSQL. So right now we can see the version 13, and here we have link something called download installer. So just click on it. So here in the next page you will see this this database version 13.4 as the latest version, and here we have Windows 64-bit, and here you have this download button. So just click on it. So now you can see our Postgres database download is started. It may take a while, and we'll wait till download is completed, and we'll resume our PostgreSQL database installation. So it looks like our download is completed. So now let's go to download folder, and here you can see the exe file for our PostgreSQL database. So for installation, just double click on this exe. Let me minimize all the stuff. So our PostgreSQL database installation is started, and this is our first phase of our setup. So here it says welcome to PostgreSQL wizard, and just click on next. And here you can see this is going to install under C program file program SQL 13. And if you want to change this path, and if you want to save some directory or D drive or E drive, you can click on this button and you can change it. But yeah, I'm gonna go with this default one and just click on next. So here it says all this component, the PostgreSQL server, PG admin force, take builder and command line. So it's gonna install all this for software, and now let's click on next. And here this is my data directory. It's under C program file PostgreSQL 13 and data. So let's go with the default for this as well and click on next. And here you're gonna set up the password for your PostgreSQL. So let's set the password. And yeah, make a note of this password, because you're gonna need this password when you log in into your PostgreSQL database. So just make a note of this password. And now let's click on next. And here this the port number, it says 5432. Let's go with the default and click on next. So here we go with the default and click on next. And yeah, we are ready to install this PostgreSQL, and just click on next. So now it says setup is now ready to begin installation Postgres on your computer. So let's click on next, and our installation process is started. So let's wait till the installation process is completed, and we'll resume our video. So our installation process is completed, and here we have checkbox called the stack builder may use to download and install additional tools, driver and application to be complement your Postgres installation. So yeah, we are not going to install any driver or any tools, so just uncheck it and click on finish. So now let's open the pgAdmin to connect to our Postgres database. So let's search for pgAdmin. So here we have pgAdmin 4, so just click on it. So this will launch your pgAdmin, which is nothing but the management tool for your PostgreSQL database. So our pgAdmin is open, and here we have to enter our password which we set while installation. So let's enter our password and say OK. And here you can see the servers. Now let's expand the server. And when you expand that, it will try to connect to your server. So when you try to connect to your server, you have to enter your password. So let's again enter the password and say save the password and say OK. So here we have something called database. So let's expand this database, and this is our dashboard where you can see all this activity on your Postgres database. Here you have SQL, so which is the console to write the SQL. And here by default you can see this your one database called Postgres. So now let's create our own database. So right click on database, create data, and here you have create and click on database. So now let's give our database name. So I call it MyDB. And if I go to the SQL, I can see the syntax for this creating the database. So it says create database, the database name with all this other features, options, and now says save. So our database is created. Here you can see MyDB. So when you click on this one, by default it will be connected to MyDB. And here you can see this all this thing. Now let's expand the schemas. So here you can see your public schema, and in public schema you have this views, types, tables. So let's expand the tables. You don't have any tables, so right now let's right click on table and say create table. So here I see my table, maybe TBL, and let's enter the column. So I say head. So here I say A. So let's select integer and say save it. So you can here you can see my table is created. So now if you want to query your table, so just right click on this one and say query tool. So here you say select star from my TBL. Now let's select this and say execute. So here we don't have any records, so we cannot see any record. Now let's insert some records inside this table. So I say insert into my TBL in bracket, I say 1, and now let's execute it. I think we have to enter the values, and now let's execute this. So one row is inserted. Now let's enter the second one. So second row is inserted into our table. Now let's delete this, and now let's say select star from table and let's execute this. So here you can see this two record, 1 and 2. So this is how you can create the table inside PostgreSQL database. And yeah, that's all for PostgreSQL database installation process. Hope this video will help you to install PostgreSQL database on your Windows system. And thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next video.